大家好，Welcome back to Edupedia World Videos. Thanks for coming back to lesson 10.3, where I will give you a test. I hope you are excited about testing how you are doing with my lessons. So I hope in the end you get good results. Okay, let's get started. For the first part of the test, I want you to introduce yourself with the words that you know, okay? Using the words that I have taught you. And hopefully, you have remembered them, you have memorized them well, okay? And for this test, you can use the following as a guide. So you know what to say. Like what I have shown you in the slides. Okay? So first up, you can greet everyone before you start. It can be good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, depending where you want the time to be. And of course, next you want to tell everyone your name. Okay, when you are giving a name, you may not be able to give your Chinese name for now because you haven't learned many of the vocabulary to express your name. So for this, just put in your English name or some other your native language name in it. Okay, don't be too pressured about having your own Chinese name, okay? And if you don't mind, you can tell how old you are and also tell people about your birthday so everyone can celebrate for you. And if you can, tell everyone what you like to do, your hobbies, etc. And if it's possible, you tell people about your profession as well. If I have taught you, or you can pretend you are one if you want. And of course, tell people how many siblings you have. That is a pretty straightforward one. And other than these, you can also feel free to add anything that you want to. Okay? So, about three lines of it should be fine, as long as you are utilizing all the vocabs that you have learned, you should be able to come up with one for about 30 seconds. So good luck with it, and remember, before you end, thank everyone before you go. Okay, that's being polite as well. Okay, so give yourself some time, prepare for it. You can pause here as however long you want to, and then you can write a script using the guides I've shown here. You can also try to speak without a script, that's even perfect. You can do whatever you want to as long as it helps you to learn better in this test. And hopefully you don't have to refer to the slides of the previous lessons. So here is just to test if you can write and speak. Try practice it with yourself. Try doing this, and then I will have the sample answer that you can look at. Okay? Please make sure that you have written the script and also have tried to speak it out yourself before looking at the sample answer. And off you go. Okay, so I hope you did well. Been okay to come up with your own answer. And here I will show you the sample answer and see if it really helps you to further memorize what you have learned before. So I hope you can read this as well as you are looking at the sample answer. Okay, please pause this so that you can read this So in countdown to three, I will read it up for you. Okay, so I'll read it out now, so listen carefully. 大家好, 我是Johnny, 我今年27岁, 我是一名销售员, 我的生日是在9月16日。我有两个姐姐和一个弟弟，我喜欢看书，我想学写中文和说普通话，我想要一个女朋友，谢谢大家。OK，so I hope you got the similar content and also to understand the text. I've also prepared the translation so you can refer to it as you are. If you struggle to understand the text, hopefully you are not. And also, I hope you can compare what you think you understand it as and check if you are correct. Okay? So here it is. It is, hello everyone, 大家好. As you know, I always start these three little words as I start this video. And what's Johnny? I'm Johnny. I'm 27 years old this year. This should be easy. I am a salesperson. My birthday is on 16th September. I have two elder sisters and a younger brother. I like to read. Of course, you can also say I like reading. I want to learn writing Chinese and speaking Mandarin. Okay, so if you want to say, I want to learn writing, it is just as simple as to just direct translate it without putting any words in between. Just the original word like want is 想, learn is 学, write is 写. So it's just three, these three, 想学, 写, these three words coming together. Okay? And of course, you can also say, 我要学写中文, or 我要学写中文. They all make sense. Okay? And last one, I want a girlfriend. Okay, this should be simple enough. 我想要一个女朋友. Okay? For this one, you can say, 我要一个女朋友. But if you say, 我想一个女朋友, it's just like you are thinking about your girlfriend. So it doesn't really make sense of that. So just say either 我想要一个女朋友 or 我要一个女朋友. So 谢谢大家 is thanks everyone, because you can say 谢谢你. But to thank everyone, you can just say 谢谢大家. Okay? So I hope this all makes sense to you and been doing well for this test so far. The next one will be the last test question. Okay, for this test, I will read out a speech and see if you can understand. So this text is an introduction and the content will be similar to what you have seen just now, but a bit of variation. So, listen carefully and see if you can understand. Okay, here it goes. 老师们、同学们，大家早上好。我是 Mary，今年32岁。这是我的先生。我和他学了3个月的中文。我会看一些中文字和听明白一点点普通话，我想和大家做朋友，谢谢大家。Okay, so that's the end of what I said. So if you need to repeat that, just feel free to pause now and start the speaking again. Okay? You can do this as many times as you like, and of course, no one will know except for you. So This one is just to get you to understand Mandarin. Okay, good luck for it. Now I will show you the text, and please pause now if you are still writing it. So there will be countdown to three before I show this. Okay, here it goes. Okay, so here's the text, and please pause now to have a look at it and have a read and see if you can understand the text as well, just like the last test question that you had. Okay? Okay, so here's the translation. Okay, let me explain to you. Teachers and fellow classmates. Okay, so 老师们 is to address to number of teachers. 同学们 is again addressed to large number of students. So you say 同学们 as fellow classmates. And 大家早上好 is good morning everyone. Okay, so if you're just saying to one person, just say 早上好. And of course it doesn't make sense if you say 你早上好, but it works for 大家早上好, 大家下午好, 大家晚上好. It all makes sense. Okay? 我是 Mary. My name is Mary. I am 32 years old this year. So you notice that I don't say 我今年32岁. 我 is omitted there because it is understood that this you are saying about yourself. So you don't have to add 我 over there. Okay, this is my husband, 这是我的先生. 我和他学了3个月的中文, he and I. So in Chinese, it's much more common if you say 我和他, 我和你, rather than the other way around. But in English, I know it's more common for putting I the last. Okay? So he and I learned Chinese for 3 years. Again, you should be very familiar with this grammar structure because I have explained to you before. 三个月 is like an adjective, so it's placed before 中文, Chinese, and it has the in between. Okay? I can read some Chinese words and understand a little Mandarin. 我会看一些中文字. Okay, so 会 here is translated as can. And also understand speaking, you can say 听明白. And the rest you should understand it. It's just very similar to the sample sentence that I covered in the lessons. Okay. Now you know that 一些 means some. Okay? So, 我想和大家做朋友. For this one, I just want you to guess like what it means by 做朋友. Okay? So, I haven't taught this word, but I hope you can derive that 做朋友 means to be friends. Okay? I want to be friends with everyone. 我想和大家做朋友. In direct translation, it becomes I want with everyone be friends. Okay, I know it sounds counterintuitive, but it's just like how you deal with time. Okay, if you really want to translate I want to be friends with everyone in to Chinese directly, it's like 我想做朋友和大家, right? But like time, the with everyone is like a description to the action of be friends. So because of that, it is placed in front of 做朋友, because it is describing that with everyone is connected to be friends. Okay? Just like 我想在星期三见我的儿子。It is very much like you substitute 在星期三 to 和大家 because both are like describing the actions that you want to do. Okay? You will encounter more of these in the future. So don't panic if you still don't understand that. You'll get used to it as I introduce more and more of this sentence structure. Okay? And the end, you thank everyone. So it's just to say, 谢谢大家. Okay? So this is all the tests that I have for you for this lesson. So I hope you did well and can make sense most part of it. And if you don't, please go back to the previous lessons and have a look at them so you catch up with the future lessons as we go along. Okay? Next up is Chinese name system. Okay? So you may have known some Chinese name, like some politicians and stars, but sometimes you don't really know how to address one person. So the next lesson, I'm gonna tell you how our name system work. Which one are the family name, which one is the given name, and how we arrange that. Okay? It is easy. Of course, this Chinese name system only applies to Han descendants, so it doesn't include the ethnic minority. So bear this in mind as I go into next lesson. As I said, the next lesson, there won't be new words, but it's for your knowledge to get used to our culture. And hopefully, you can also give yourself a Chinese name if you want. Okay? So, thank you for taking the test, and I'm looking forward to teach you a bit about Chinese culture. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.
Drop a like and do share. Leave your comments, and do not forget to subscribe for more videos.